since I was legit. Ever since I blew, they all on my dick. Hey, back then, didn't know I exist. Don't touch my cup, you know how I sip. Hey, got your blown. That I made her when I showed out my whip. Hey, spent about 10 on my 15. Hey, slick, then hit with the back then, you out the zip. Blow out the back, then dip. Got a whole party all on the ship. All these four things pull out the vip. Suck, turn up, baby, pour out the milk. Tell you know how I drip. Crush.
With a December snow blanketing much of the Midwest and Northeast, what a perfect time to be in the Sunshine State as we welcome you to TIAA Bank Field in Jacksonville, Florida. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Cleveland Browns and the Jacksonville Jaguars. Three quarters of the NFL season are complete. What lurks in our final month? We're underway in week 14. This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. At their own 25-yard line.
It's up. Lee.
Check, check. No. Let's go.
Here we go. Kick, kick, kick.
First and 10 for Dalton. The open man is Westbrook, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A big one there for the Jags, 18 yards, first down. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Play action here with Dalton. Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on this first drive. Instead, second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, you need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
On second down, Swift. And he stopped immediately there. The tackle made by the linebacker, Joe Schobert.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers putting their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. And Yeah, last week in the loss, 5 punts as he gets this one away. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. A first carry now for Nick Chubb. He'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 23.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They go with Chubb on second down. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
So a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. A.J. Boye with a pick.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
There, D gets the INT. Now what can Dalton do? Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. They had great starting position to begin the drive, and now they look up at a 3rd and 5. Dalton here from the gun. And that ball is caught by DJ Chark for the Jags touchdown. DJ Chark. His 4th touchdown on the year as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Josh Lambeau now for the point after. And this is up and good. The score now 7-0 Jaguars. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start 1st and 10. They run on 1st down as they're able to get this forward for about 4. Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a 1st down.
It's a gain of 6. And the Browns 1st down.
Hey,
pick your game up. 3-3. Check number 6. Check number 6.
They go play action. Mayfield. Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick. But instead, it falls down incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from the 29.
50 to Mike. 50 to Mike.
Mayfield looks to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, helped force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. Mayfield. He finds Beckham. Complete. And he's got the first down. Yardage before being taken down at midfield. 21 yards there on third down.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Pressure comes and down goes Baker Mayfield. Finding his way home for the sack that time, Taven Bryant.
Tremendous read and reaction by the defensive tackle. And frankly, partner, it's not that often the DTs have that type of easy access back to the quarterback. Never bought the play action fake.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Throwing Mayfield toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Will Fuller was the intended target, and it's third down.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
He'll let it go deep for Beckham, and that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's fourth down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels. Let's go old school there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in one.
And they'll bring him down right around the 13. It's a gain of five, and it'll make it second down. Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Dalton now to pass. And that'll be incomplete. Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks who make quick decisions and have quick releases have the most success in this league.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete. Credit that breakup to Greedy Williams.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
On is the punt team now as this one sent away. Now Landry. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the Browns will take over first and 10. The Browns drive about to get started, and the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. So that's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play. At the
45-yard line. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. It was Taven Bryan who got him down defensively.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
Let's get off the field.
Regular. Pilot, 64, weak.
Mike 47.
On third down, Mayfield. And he's got his man. That's Landry. Shedding the tackler, and it gives him some room. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. They'll get 34 yards there.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game.
On first down, Chubb going to get forward for only about a couple. Second and eight, fourth coming. Calais Campbell on the stop.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man.
Point it right.
Throwing on second and eight, Mayfield. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Nick Chubb, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Yeah, good game catching the ball in the backfield a week ago. They're going to try and involve him in that way in this game as well, but you can tell scouting is taking over. They're making it a little bit more difficult.
Yeah, defensively, they told us, hey, we've got to take him out of the passing game, limit it to just short runs, because he can really...
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Odell Beckham hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Extra point right down the middle, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
Play fake. Here's Dalton. Under heavy pressure, and down goes Dalton on the sack. Miles Garrett in there to bring him down, and that is sack number 17 for him now on the year. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead, and he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
Are we on the same page here, partner? Because I think they have the right idea. Just take what you can get on third and forever.
Yeah, in real life, I'd say yes. It's just these video games are tempting. You want to go downfield with it.
I like the way you've evolved. Yeah. You know, you've learned how to play it the Madden way.
Well, very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Browns drive about to get started. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display. And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Looking to throw again on second down. Mayfield. This is the tight end, Njoku. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Let's go. And the Browns first
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. These two teams all tied after one. The start of the second quarter, and it's the Browns in control of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Give the sack there to Jake Ryan.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Here's Mayfield. It's caught by OBJ. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
Mayfield from the gun on third down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
The kick by Joseph is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So a good snap, good hold, and right down the middle.
Never in doubt. Just the way you used to hit them, partner.
You mean like kicking the ball?
Exactly.
Well, that was in high school.
Doesn't matter. I don't care what level. You hit them, they go through.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Here's Dalton. And he fires one incomplete.
Well, touch and timing are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
The Jaguars on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. And he completes it to Westbrook. Touchdown, Jaguars! D.D. Westbrook with touchdown number 8 on the year. And once again, the Jaguars are back out in front.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field, and that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown.
This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I've never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you've met fan bases that wanted them, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Mayfield down, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
One of the great coaches said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. From the gun, it's a give to Chubb. And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
The Browns on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 7. From the gun, Mayfield going for the deep ball. It's caught inside the 25. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Will Fuller, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Browns have retaken the lead. Pretty good response. They had given up the touchdown and the lead, but they struck back.
And I love the way that they just saw it happen, took a quick exhale on the sidelines. So let's go get it back and fast. Let's go ahead and throw the ball downfield and get our own 6 points.
A huge chunk play to regain that lead. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
6 yard pickup. They'll come up now second and 4 from the 31. Man out of the backfield. That's complete. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up third down.
When you lose that kind of yardage on a pass play, you often expect it to be a sack, but that wasn't the case there. They completed the pass. Probably would have been better off just dropping the football and making an incompletion as opposed to catching it and losing that kind of yardage.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, they decided to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. Landry now on the return. Call that a 48-yard punt and made even better by a loss on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Browns drive about to get started. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
They run again on first down, Chubb. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4. From the 45 on second down, Mayfield. He's got Njoku, his big tight end. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 39. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on 2nd and 10. Mayfield to throw it. They set up the screen to Chubb. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll be a 3rd and about 13. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Josh Allen, he continues to wreak havoc in the offensive backfield. Sack number 16 on the year. Here's Brian Anger now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting. Now that's the way you want to start a drive. Talk about a tone setter as well as a playbook opener. Now if you want to take a big shot over the top, you're all positioned to do so.
On 2nd down now, Swift. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 2nd quarter action, 1:56 remaining. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Looking deep downfield. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked. 2nd down.
Fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect, but as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm.
Dancing to his left. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a 3rd down situation. Fight it. 3rd down, a shot here for Dalton. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's 4th down.
Trying to get that one to his tight end, and they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet, unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And here's a fair catch taken at about the 24-yard line. Just 21 yards on the punt there. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. A 1st down throw for Mayfield. Got an open man. That's David Njoku, the tight end. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Throwing again on 2nd down, Mayfield, and that's going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's 3rd down.
We've already seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half, unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting him the ball out of the passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is, because he catches it well, creates a mismatch. You're going to cover him with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he can win every battle.
He's got Fuller. Oh, good move. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Going to the air again with Mayfield. It's caught. Beckham. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one.
I'm letting you know right now, you got 61. Matchbox lights.
Kill, kill, kill.
My touch.
They go play action. Mayfield. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver. But it's going to be second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
On second down, Mayfield again. This short pass into the hands of Njoku. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches.
Hey, alert, 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 alert! He's got
and again, it's Mayfield. He sets to fire deep. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now. It's a 47-yard field goal try from here, but instead they're going to opt to go for it on fourth down.
You go tight. You got tight. You got tight right there.
I touch.
51, Mike. Mike, 51.
I touch.
Right here, guys. Mike, 51. Mike, 51.
Hey, we got to get that.
He's coming. Double up, double up. He's coming. Double up.
I touch.
And they're out of timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. That's going to set them back 5 yards. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And this one is right down the middle. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
This is fielded at the goal line. I don't know what was going on there, but the end result, this is going to be a safety. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game. The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Browns drive about to get started. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. they're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
To throw on second and 10, Mayfield. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And now offensively, it's third and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now, the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half.
To throw, Mayfield. And that will be incomplete.
So no problems moving the ball in the first half, but they'll likely come up empty here on drive one of quarter three.
And it was so important for the defense to get that stop because what we witnessed in the first half was them getting run over. And they needed the confidence, and they needed to get off the field so they felt good going forward in this game.
Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve.
On second and 10, Dalton. It'll be a pickup of 8 on the screen, and it sets up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on third down. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. Well, the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on 4th and 3. So they are going for it. Now Dalton. This one complete into the hands of Higgins. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
Watch twist.
Here we go. Can.
The first down throw coming for Dalton. And nearly picked off there, and it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down. They got the win last week despite not having any interceptions. Tried to come up with one there, could not. But there's a stat category called PBU, pass breakup. That's important too, and they got one.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it because at least you're there knocking the ball away. Offense isn't possessing it, making plays downfield. And you just continue to harass the receivers, harass the quarterback, and maybe the big play does occur down the road.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Terrence Mitchell. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film, extra time. You know those guys watched him all week, saw how precise he was, and constructed a defense to try and chip away at that, and thus far they've been successful.
It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Mayfield now, 5 straight completions here in this second half, 1st and 10.
Check nine.
They give the Chubb out of the gun. He'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Check, check, 47. Regular, regular, regular. Our QB's up.
Hey, a 133.
Twins. From the 39, Mayfield. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. What a difference a week makes. Last week he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week he's down under 50%. What do you see as the difference?
Well, I think we're used to seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going to hold that number, not in this league. But a drop under 50%, that just tells me that the defense, they spent a lot of extra time on game films and came up with a really good plan to try and chip away at his timing.
On third down, Mayfield. He rifles one that's intercepted. A.J. Bourrier with a pick. And the return stops at the 39-yard line.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his second interception of the game. And so much of playing defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves.
In a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Greedy Williams picks it off. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys are tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. Now a throw here going to be taken in by the tight end, Njoku. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 50 catches for him now on the year, and he's got a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A run for Nick Chubb. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
And again, it's Chubb. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop it. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. And now the throw going to Fuller, and he's got it. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back.
Mike's 50, Mike's 50.
Come on, run, run.
Tag it right.
Hey, four down.
Mike 50, Mike 50. I got it.
Third and long for Mayfield. He's got his tight end, David Njoku. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 28. This quarterback now over 300 yards now for the game, and time to improve on that as he's got a first and 10. Now Mayfield. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And this is caught for a Browns touchdown by Landry. Jarvis Landry, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. Extra point splits the uprights, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Joseph now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally, we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Give them 14 on that one and a first down. Andy Dalton now, a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. And Dalton to throw. And he rifles one incomplete.
Coverage was great everywhere that time. He tried to get it to his outlet, tried to get it to his running back, but sailed it a little bit too high and actually left his body open for a big hit.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing again. Dalton. He's going to let this go for the end zone. Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. This will be Dalton again. He's got the hook up to Lee. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That one goes for 24 yards.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. To throw again. Dalton. That one complete. He finds Sharp. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. A gain there of 21 yards. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And now a timeout called defensively by the Browns. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
He got 368.
They'll try to run this one in, and he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. A great play there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. As they're now just an extra point away from getting back within one score. Extra point tacked on by Lambeau. And this is back to an 8-point game. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Browns drive about to get started, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking to get it to Jarvis Landry that time. And now it's third down.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past. The biggest teaching point, get your head around, locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Mayfield from the gun on third down. Open man, he completes it to Callaway, and he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 14 yards, and it's a Cleveland first down. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. On the carry, it's Chubb, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Here's Mayfield. Being chased out left. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
It's nothing like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left. Contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
Throwing again, Mayfield on second and 10. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete. Here's Brian Anger now. He's been terrific so far. .46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. On first down, Swift. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Back now in Jacksonville. It's Jaguar football, but a little work to do for them. They trail here as we start the fourth. A pass there, complete to Westbrook. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal, don't necessarily need a touchdown.
368!
Play action now, Dalton. Under heavy pressure and down goes Dalton on the sack. Jannard Avery in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. Third down, a shot here for Dalton. Looking left side, and it's complete. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Here's Dalton. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the former first-round pick, Demarius Randle. And the return stops just a little bit shy of midfield at the 48-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and give these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. A give running right is Chubb. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 11 yards there, first down. Well, that looked like an example of what you said back in the first half. A running back of his size can really wear down a defense. I think he's starting to do that.
I think you're exactly right. And know what else he's doing? He's inspiring the rest of his team because they see this starting to happen as well. So that means they're going to redouble their efforts to help him out. Extra blocking, getting downfield, helping him out.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41. Now Chubb. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
First down marker at the 31. It's 3rd down. Mayfield looks to throw. And he gets it to his running back, Nick Chubb. And they'll get him down at the 34, and he's going to be short of the first by a few yards.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catch. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is 4th down. Mayfield to throw for it on 4th. And this is caught. He hits Landry. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good pickup there for the Browns, 15 yards. Felt compelled to go for it there on 4th down, trailing in the 4th quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a 4th down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You still have to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Set, 180.
Check, 47. Watch the pass.
From the red zone now, Mayfield. And he's got it. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last 2 plays. So 1st and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping
check
this one up. They'll give it to Chubb, and he's in. Touchdown, Browns. Nick Chubb hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. Now, let's not forget that was all set up by the 4th down conversion earlier in the drive.
Would have been a complete letdown if the drive doesn't culminate this way, wouldn't it? If you're going to go for it on 4th down, your intention is to make sure you get a touchdown out of the drive. And that's exactly what they did. Converted, and it converted a 2nd time for 6 points.
Point after, right down the middle. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Joseph now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you... Under heavy pressure and down goes Dalton on the sack.
Sheldon Richardson, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Play action here with Dalton. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
Say. Two by two. Move.
Third and long. What will Dalton dial up? And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. They'll try on fourth. Here's Dalton. This one complete into the hands of Higgins. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Another chance for Dalton. And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Miles Garrett in there to get him, and that is now sack number 18 on the season for him. Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Dalton. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 49. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch-counterpunch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload, but you and I both know. Well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
They'll run with Chubb, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Now from the 9, here's second and goal. A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. And it'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Under 4 to play now. Clock running. Third down. From the gun, Mayfield. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
So with that, you figure this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from 3 scores down, but don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive, and they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
But this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 11 yards there, first down. From midfield here, Dalton. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down.
Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense that's well coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure, the backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. And it'll be Dalton again. Open man is Higgins. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 39.
That's a pretty good throw on the curl route there. Third down, and they pick up a first.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
They should be aware, but it was so hard sometimes.
No, it's not easy.
Because when they sell that route really well, you think they're going upfield, then they curl back, show their numbers.
And he's
going
to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Robert Quinn in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing on second and long, Dalton. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
I'm here all day. I'm here all day.
Sorry. 368.
Hey, turn it up. Turn it up.
They'll try to pass on fourth down. Dalton, he's going to let it fly. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position. First down, they'll run with Hunt. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
They'll run again with Hunt. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He lost two there, and it's third down. Mayfield on third and two. Pressure comes and down goes Baker Mayfield. Yannick Ngakoue. He continues to wreak havoc in the offensive backfield. Sack number 16 on the year. Here's Brian Anger now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. The open man is Westbrook. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
368!
Dalton here from the gun. This pass complete to Higgins. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Now Dalton with a first and 10. That one complete. He finds Sharp. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And with inside of 10 seconds, 8 to be precise, we get whistles and a timeout on the field. Dalton operating in the red zone now. Got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. From 19 yards away. And the Jaguars make some inroads here on that deficit.
That's almost just not right. You cover everybody. But those tight ends, they can be awfully reliable.
Very reliable. The defense just has to hate those guys.
This drives them crazy because oftentimes you can't match up with them. They have you either with size, speed, or maybe even just strength.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This will be taken very short. So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And it was Baker Mayfield who led the way, the number one pick in 2018. He showed why he was so coveted.
And it was interesting because you remember headed into the draft in 2018, the projections on where Baker Mayfield was going to go, it varied. But rarely did anyone suggest he would go number one overall. And he did. Showed exactly why. It's not just how he plays. It's not just his arm and his vision. It's the leadership, it's the toughness, it's the moxie that he exhibits, and his teammates just feed off of it.
So for Cleveland, their very slim playoff hopes remain as they move to 6-7 on the year.
There ain't no time, is it? Playing skills, you did. Flavor, huh? I think it's good. I think it's good.
since I blew they out on my ain't back then, then no I exist. Don't touch my cup, you know how I sip. Hey, got your long that I made her when I showed out my whip. Hey, spent my 10 on my 15. X slick, then hit with the back then, you should out the zip. Blow out his back, then dip. Got a whole for the all on the ship. All these four things pull out the vip. Suck to a nut, baby, pour out the milk. So you know how I drip. Crush.
This magic with the gang, we ball out, it can't get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dreams reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laughing. Now I hit the scene, they like lights, camera, action. Living in a dream, now my music, they be blasting. Step out, I'm a star, always in the latest fashion. Had to set the bar, try to catch me lacking. Bank account for my son, he won't have to struggle. You can see it in my eyes, all I do is hustle. They tried to knock me off my feet, I'm ready to rumble. Feel like I ain't ate in weeks, working off the muscle. Oh yeah, oh my, we ride. For my brothers, no lie, all you can die. Never wrong, they right, I ain't changing my side. Yeah, we in it for life. And I've been up this magic. With the gang, we ball out, it can't get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dream's reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laugh. Hey, how could you lie to my face? People claim that they be loyal, they be taking up space. See my broski lose his heart when he was fighting that case. Took so many yells, I'm not going back to those days. I'ma treat you how you treat me, do you like how it tastes? Shawty, use a can't treat you like my ace. I got way too many problems to be worried, I'm straight. Me and Craig had to watch for the Jakes. On the road, this crazy, I get 80 a show. Say my money, stack it up, it look like I'm foreign cars, driving fast, I never done this before. Get drown out my problems, let me when I've been up is magic. With the gang, we ball out, it can't get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dream's reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laughing.
Wear ball mains. All I ever do is ball main. I am not a rapper, they all lame. am not dope, I'm hard. Wait, I got power up and level up at any moment. Spitting like a semi, only give me semicolon. Couple zeros like I'm sending yell nets. Every flow is unmatched and I better get set in. Finish them,
finish them.
Messing around with me and I diminish them all. Even if I ever did the minimum all. In the end result, I'm better killing them all. Rogue one, but I got a team with me. Batman when I got a thing with me. I get mean, I get green. Show the whole game what's never been seen. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan, Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan, Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank.
Designer sneakers hurt my feet now. Every beat is getting beat down. Couldn't eat, watch I eat now. Like how you getting paid to freestyle? Different cities every week now. Every woman is now. With state prop, you looking bleak now. I was home to sleep designing sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find a social fishing. Who the crew? It wasn't you. I know it's true, cause you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kinda made my stomach turn when I brung it up. Wait.
Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan, Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan, Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me by a cell. I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. Get it by myself, I'ma get it by myself, yeah. Feel like Ginger from Casino, aces up my sleeve though.